Well, I don't think she figures it out yet. But anyway,
Carol, some more pictures. I can put them in the video, the picture video.
Yeah, that would be nice. But anyway, she loves Nia, and I think she's getting another, so I hope so. That's cool. I hope I hadn't ratted her out. She may not have told other people that. I don't know. Well, they know it now.
FYI, folks. Heard it here first.
Yeah, I don't think it's right, definite, but we'll see.
Maybe.
Yeah. So, wait, we're kind of boring today.
I know. It's not very
exciting. Oh, you know what I'll talk about just real quickly, because I was thinking about yesterday. I mentioned the whole thing about overpopulation. You know, I just worry that in this day and age, we're still not discussing what is going to be a huge problem on our planet, which is overpopulation. Now, I don't suggest that we do anything to undermine people procreating, because I just don't think that is something people can even consider or think about. But with that said, are we worrying about things like how we're depleting the water tables in so many communities? And, you know, should there be more emphasis on creating desalinization plants to be able to reclaim water from the sea? I mean, you see it in third world countries where what we take for granted, such as drinking water and, you know, simple food to eat, is a problem in continents like Latin America and Asia and Africa. And I don't think these are problems that are going to go away. And unless, you know, certainly we're not going to discuss, you know, limiting population, although I think Mother Nature takes care of that in her own way by creating disease and creating gay men and gay women so that they
and
stop
creating, working. You know, to some extent, you know, Mother Nature also created the badness in the world to deplete.
Whether like wars
or, you know, that issue in Darfur where people are killing other people, which is horrible, but they were also created too.
Yeah, it is. And I think that the answer is that we could be much more positive about the way we looked at things like particularly global warming, listen to these scientists, put money into some of these things that could be... You are a nut.
I was totally into the conversation. I was paying.
I know. You look like that lady on... who is on... Oh, shoot, I can't think of her name. She was the maid on the Jeffersons.
Wheezy?
No, that was Mrs. Jefferson.
I met her, too. I met her when I met Carol Burnett.
Right.
She was there. Marla Gibbs. She was also on 227.
Yeah, she was.
I can't remember her name on the show.
And on 227, speaking of Marla Gibbs, there was another woman on that. Her name was...
Jackie!
No. Oh, I like Jackie, too, but... Helen Johnson.
Mary.
Remember the old lady who lived on the first floor and she would hang out the window?
Yes, the older lady.
Helen Johnson. Helen Johnson was in the first musical that I mentioned the other day that I saw, Raisin.
I love Raisin. I saw, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, it was a musical version of Raisin in the Sun. But anyway, she was in that show. Remember I told you Debbie Allen was in it? And all?
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I saw a Raisin in the Sun in Atlanta with Esther Rowland.
Oh, right. Neat.
So
I bet she was on there. I saw Virginia Capers. Oh, and you're talking about, can I tell my theater story?
Oh, yeah. Just so everyone knows, you can still send in your entries for the 3-pack DVD set Broadway, the American Musical, for your best Broadway story. We've gotten a couple in the runnings, and we're going till, I don't know, I said Monday, but we might go a little longer because I want to hear people's Broadway stories. So go ahead, tell me yours.
Well, the very first time that I ever went to see a Broadway show, I must have been about 15 or 16 years old. A friend of mine, John, and I got on a bus from Philadelphia and took a bus, well, it was a suburb of Philadelphia, up into New York City at the Port Authority. We got this dumpy hotel on right by where the waterfront is on the Hudson where all of the ships come in. It's actually not bad now, but in that day it was pretty creepy. And it was a dumpy hotel. We had one night there. We went to TKTS, where you get half-price tickets. That afternoon, we got tickets to Raisin, and that night, we had tickets to a show called Lorelei with Carol Channing. Now, Raisin, as I mentioned, was the musical version of Raising the Sun. Virginia Capers, Joe Morton, who is still a pretty successful actor. I think he's got a TV show right now. And just taking over the role of Benita was a young Debbie Allen. She came out of the corner and stepped into the role. And after the show, we stayed at the stage door, and Joe and... Debbie sat there and talked to us for, I don't know, a good, well, it seemed like hours. It was probably a good 10 minutes, but
aww.
It was really neat. And that night, we went to see Lorelei, which was a revival of Gentlemen Prefer Blondes, the musical. And it was Carol Channing in the title role and Peter Palmer, who played Abner in Little Abner on Broadway. And this was at the Palace Theater, which actually got me my first idea of what I want happened if when I die. I want my ashes cremated and put in the ventilation system of the Palace Theater so I can just become dust and watch everything that happens there. But anyway, when you walk into the Palace Theater, you know that that's where Judy Garland played and all of this great history. And it's one of the few theaters that actually faced Broadway. And
that's where Color Purple is now, right?
No, no, that's the Broadway Theater.
Oh, sorry.
We saw Aida at the Palace Theater.
Oh, right, Aida. Now there's, All Shook Up was there, and then now is...
I don't know what that
is. Blank.
But anyway, in the second act of Lorelei, it's right before she's about to sing Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend. And the orchestra begins, and her microphone goes out, her wireless microphone. So she stops all of a sudden, and she looks at the audience and goes, "Ladies and gentlemen, just one moment, please. I don't want you to miss one moment of this immortal song." So then she goes and she walks off stage, leaving the stage empty. A second or two later, she comes back out with a handheld corded wire mic, and she's pulling that out, and she goes, "Mr. Conductor, if you please." And he started the song, and she sang the entire song, "Gentlemen Prefer Blonde," "Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend," holding the microphone. So as the applause begins, she walks off stage, hands the microphone up, and comes back in, and everyone comes on stage. Lo and behold, the microphones are still not fixed. So she says, "Ladies and gentlemen, please, one more moment, please." And she steps off stage, gets the hardwired microphone back, and it's a big scene with, I don't know, 10 or 15 people, and she walks around and puts the microphone up to everyone's mouth as they have a line. Excepting when finally it comes to the time where Peter Palmer breaks down and finally asks Lorelei to marry him, and she's supposed to say no. But she got so confused, she said yes, which of course would have screwed up the whole rest of the play. So they all started to crack up. Anyway, that was my first day of theater.
So what'd she do, yes? I mean, no?
Yeah. She did. And they had to kind of go back. I think Peter Palmer had to say, "I don't think you meant that." It's funny, but that was my theater.
And she doesn't exit out the stage door. She didn't there.
She didn't. She walked through the theater and got in a limousine out front. Now, this was back in the 70s.
Yeah.
Early 70s. But she did. She walked out the front through the under the marquee and got into a limousine and didn't sign autographs, but, you know, she kind of waved. You met Carol Channing, too, here in Orlando, didn't you?
Not Carol Channing, no.
Oh. Never mind.
I met Dolly Parton here in Orlando.
Yeah, for some reason I thought you said you had met Carol Channing. She's cool, though.
I wish.
Oh, we have to get Miles to tell the Carol Channing
story. Oh, I know. We have to get him next week at the hotel.
He's going to be at the hotel Tuesday and Wednesday. We're going to get a special guest appearance with Miles.
That's a great story.
It is. We're not going to tell anymore, but it's a Carol
Channing.
There's
lots of stars involved. Beth Midler, Carol Channing.
We're going to get him to tell the story.
So, well, I guess that's all we have time for today. Cause
how long are we again?
We're at 14.
Gosh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right, you guys. Well, happy Father's Day out there.
Have a great Father's Day, and if you haven't called your father already, do it now.
Yeah.
And that's all I have to say, I guess.
That's it. Bye, everybody.
Good to see you, everyone. See you tomorrow.
Bye.